It's nighttime in the big city. The air is thick with a chemical tang. A woman takes a shower before going home to her husband. It's Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
It's time for Theme Time Radio Hour. Dreams, games, and themes. From blues to boogie, from bop to rap. Tonight we're going to reach out and touch someone with the telephone. On the way to the studio, I almost hit a telephone operator with my car. It was a close call.
The number you have reached has been disconnected.
Telephone was invented by Alexander Graham Bell, whose wife and mother were deaf. He invented it to try to improve on the telegraph, which was a way of sending messages, which they just closed. He thought when people answered the phone, they should say, ahoy, ahoy. Myself, I'd just say hello. He made his first telephone call to his assistant in 1876. The first thing he ever said was, Mr. Watson, come here. I want you. Here we have Elmore James saying almost the same thing with Talk to Me, Baby. For atheists, you call it Nobody Answers. Gospel always uses the newest thing. Now they even got a thing called the God Pod, an iPod with scripture in it, so you can listen wherever you go. Me, I'd rather listen to the Spirit of Memphis Quartet singing Atomic Telephone.
God help you with a great new power. What do you use for the good of all?
The atomic telephone, although then no man knows its power, oh, only God alone, although then it can cure the sick, or destroy the evil, with one sweep of power, known by God alone.
Oh, God is not to busy to know the sins of man. You may hear from heaven, you may feel his hand. If you are in trouble and afraid of all mankind, hey,
pick up the atomic telephone and get him on the line.
Hey, I got to talk to Jesus
on the atomic telephone. Oh, then
no man knows his power.
Oh,
only God alone.
Oh, all in
it can cure the sick or destroy their evil.
With one sweep of power known by God alone.
Oh, for this call to heaven, there will be no choice. Just like old man Noah, who prayed from an ark, you can ask your God just what to do. He'll lead you from the wilderness and out of the dark.
Oh,
hey, I got to talk to Jesus
on the atomic telephone.
Hey, well, then no man knows his power.
Oh,
only God alone.
Oh, well, then
it can cure the sick or destroy their evil.
With one sweep of power known by God alone.
I can talk to Jesus
on the atomic telephone.
Oh, then no man knows his power.
Oh,
only God alone.
All of them,
it can cure the sick or destroy their evil.
With one sweep of power known by God alone.
Atomic telephone. Use it for the good of all mankind. No man knows the power. Can't heal the sick, can't raise the dead. Atomic telephone, Spirit of Memphis Quartet. Pennsylvania 65000. This was the phone number of the Hotel Pennsylvania, which at that time was known as the Statler Hotel. And Glenn Miller used to play there. This song was sort of an ad where you could call up the hotel and ask what time you could see him play. He also said that this was the phone number he called when he proposed to his wife.
Pennsylvania 6-5000.
Glenn Miller was one of the most popular entertainers in the 30s and 40s and disappeared under mysterious circumstances during World War II while on a flight to entertain U.S. troops in France. Etta James, all you got to do is let me hear your voice. Etta's still going strong. In 2003, she received a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. I got to call her and congratulate her. That was Etta James, sometimes known as Miss Peaches, discovered by Johnny Otis in 8423089. Do you ever want to write a song with your phone number? Here's a little tip. Hero rhymes with zero. This is Theme Time Radio Drizzle Mosh Nizzle. This record is just a mystery. Don't know who it is, where it was done. Doesn't stop me from playing it, though. It's just like the phone when it rings. You don't know who it's going to be, but you got to answer it. I feel like talking, been out balling. Phone is busy. I wonder who's on that line. Telephone Blues, Eddie Gorman and his group.
Man, you sure is playing some fine piano this morning. But I got the blues for my baby. Operator, operator, give me a line. I feel like talking to that gal of mine. Been calling and calling a long, long time. I've been out balling and I sure feel fine. But a phone is busy and I wonder who's on that line. Well, I tried and tried to call that gal of mine. Yes, I tried and tried to call that gal of mine. Man, a phone was busy, and I wonder who's on that line. Well, it's early in the morning, and I don't know what to do. Yes, it's early in the morning, and I don't know what to do. Yeah,
about to break a day, babe. I'll be around to talk with you. Well, I'm sitting here crying and talking to myself. Yes, I'm sitting here crying and talking to myself. Man, I want my baby. Don't want nobody else. Ring, operator, ring. Blowing, and I jumped on my feet, went running to the door, and I ran out in the street. I went to a house, and I knocked on the door. Out came my clothes. I don't live there no more. My phone is busy, and I wonder who's on that line.
Eddie Gorman and his group, Telephone Blues.
Welcome to the Wurlitzer plant, home of the celebrated Wurlitzer coin-operated phonograph, or jukebox, as it is so fondly known throughout music-loving America.
Originally, the jukebox was used in duke joints. They actually took the place of live entertainment. Jukeboxes were a way for people to hear music that was not played on the radio. The first one showed up in 1927 by the Automatic Music Instrument Company. By the 50s, there was a bunch of companies making jukeboxes, including Wurlitzer, Seabird, and your favorite, my favorite, Rockola. Is it a hard decision between the jukebox and the phone? I think it depends on who's on the other end of the phone.
I can't make up my mind between the jukebox and the phone. It only takes a dime to see if she's at home. But the last time I called her, someone else was there. If I drop my dime in the jukebox, I don't suppose she cares.
Kentucky. I can't make up my mind whether to put the dime in the jukebox or the phone. One dime is all I've left. I wonder how many times I've called her on the phone. Maybe I should play another sad song. Among other sad songs Laddie wrote was Out of Control by George Jones. Here's the man himself, George Jones, nicknamed the Possum, was born with a broken arm, grew up to be one of the finest singers in country music.
Second time today,
my fingers tremble as I slowly touch the phone. I dial your number, not knowing if you're home. it rings. You answer with a sweet hello. My heart beats loudly as the teardrops start to flow. I bite my lip until the blood runs free and keep the words I love you hidden deep, deep inside of me. I hang up the wrong number. I hear you tell your friend, but I just had to hear you talking once again. Just one word and just one moment will change happiness into misery. You hang up again, and I know what you will say. Wrong number, that's the second time today. Wrong number, that's the second time today.
My fingers tremble as they try to touch the phone. A sweet hello from you, my heart beats loudly. I bite my lip until the blood begins to flow. I keep the words I love you deep inside of me. George Jones.
This is Art Linkletter. In event of atomic bombing or some other catastrophe, here's something important to remember. It will help save lives, including your own. Do not use the telephone. Leave the line open for official rescue and relief. This is your part in civil defense. Remember, don't use the phone. Leave the line clear for safety of your own life and the lives of others.
Party lines became people's everyday soap opera. A bunch of people would share one phone line and you could hear what other people were talking about. It was like listening to the radio, but it was the people next door. So of course it was fascinating. Here's the Kinks.
Hello, who's that speaking, please?
Next.
Here's another song about party lines, courtesy of Mr. Cleanhead himself, Eddie Vincent. And he was called Cleanhead because he burned all his air off with air straightener. First time I heard this song, it knocked my socks off.
Hello, Miss Jackson. I just got back to town. Your daddy's coming home, don't have nobody else around. It's the people on my party line. It's the people on my party line. I didn't mean to listen, but the conversation got so fine. He said, honey, do you love me? She said, yes, you know I do. I need some loving and I need some money too. It's the people on my party line. It's the people on my party line. I didn't mean to listen, but the conversation got so fine.
Eddie Cleanhead Vincent talking about a party line. Miss Jackson, your daddy's coming home. People on my party line, I didn't mean to listen. I need some loving. I need some money too. This is Theme Time Radio Hour, and we're on the telephone. Peter Wolf told me about a record he loves by Conway Twitty and Loretta Lynn. Pete?
Well, and speaking about telephones, there's one song that it just does it for me. This is a song that, well, it's so unique because it has two great country singers. You just pour a couple of glasses of bourbon, and it don't get any better than this. Loretta Lynn, Conway Twitty, As Soon As I Hang Up the Phone.
Hello.
Hello, Loretta.
Darling, I knew it was you.
Loretta, there's something I've just got to tell you.
Oh, please, tell me what to do.
I don't really know how to say this, but I want to tell you that
you get as soon as I picked up the phone.
No, you don't understand, Loretta. I'm trying to tell you that
the talk is around that we're through.
Yeah, I know. I've heard it too.
Oh, darling, tell me what to do.
But that's just it. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I want to tell you that
I knew you'd tell me they were wrong. As soon as I picked up the phone.
But it is true. They're not wrong.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry, Loretta.
Oh, no. I can't believe that it's true.
I'm sorry, Loretta.
Oh, no. it's over and done.
I really thought that I loved you, and you know that.
You say that you've had all your fun.
And you just got to believe me. I never meant to hurt you.
But I can't believe
this is the hardest thing that I've ever had to do. And it hurts me,
as
too.
As soon as I hang up the phone.
Yeah, I'll be gone.
As soon as I hang up the phone.
Goodbye, Loretta.
Jumpin' Jehoshaphat. You don't hear records like that anymore. We're talking about the telephone today. Here's Muddy Waters making a long-distance call. Some long-distance blues on Theme Time Radio Hour.
Darling, please call me on the phone sometime. You say you love me, darling. Please call me on the phone sometime. When I hear your voice, ease my worried mind. One of these days, I'm gonna show you how nice a man can be. I'm gonna show you just how nice a man can be. I'm gonna buy you a brand new Cadillac if you only speak some good words about me. Hear my phone ringing. Sound like a long distance call. Hear my phone keep ringing. Sound like a long distance call. When I picked up my receiver, the party said another mule kicking in your stall.
Long distance.
Operator, I'm calling Chicago. Dearborn 2, 4682.
Thank you.
Pigmeat Markham. He was born Dewey Markham in 1904 in Durham, North Carolina. He got his nickname from a song he used to sing called Sweet Papa Pig Meat. You might have recognized him when he appeared on TV on the Roland Martin Show doing Here Come the Judge. This is from the backside of the 50s when he was doing a romantic song about wiretapping.
Uh-oh, I hear an old telephone ringing again. Don't answer it. Let it alone. Once upon a time, a telephone was quite the thing. My heart just skips a beat or two each time I hear it ring. Now things have changed and nothing is like it was in yesteryear. Better take a tip from me and let me buzz this in your ear. If she calls you on the phone and say I'm your Georgia peach, if she says the coast is clear and she wants to go to the beach, if you hear a quick exposure like a face has been slapped, watch it, skip it, your wires has been tapped. If you gather the phone, just enough to greet her, and she answers in a squeaky voice, and tells you not to meet her. You anticipated romance is better off scrapped. Watch it, skip it, your wires has been tapped. Pretty soon you'll feel so groovy of the thing that you've been thinking. You feel so bold, bold as can be, of the spirits you've been drinking. Things started looking so good, you want to call up and confess. Don't do it, brother. Oh, no, man. You are deep in mess. If she swears she's at the house making coke, and you get a funny feeling as though you're about to choke, and your lights in your house flicker like the current has been trapped, watch it, skip it, your wires has been tapped. Then you consent to meet her in a real cool place, and you step out of the shadows, and you meet him face to face. Then you crack up like a tree that's been lost all its sap. Too late, brother, watch it, your wires has been tapped. Watch out, don't answer that phone. I hear it ringing again. Let it alone. Don't touch it. Please don't bother now.
Why?
Because your wires has been tapped.
All right. Wire tapping. Don't answer it. Leave it alone. Things have changed. It's nothing like it was. They say the coast is clear. She wants to go to the beach. Watch it. Skip it. Your wire has been tapped. Your artificial romance has been scrapped. Pig meat, Markham. The first wiretapping occurred during the American Civil War, when government officials under President Lincoln eavesdropped on telegraph conversations. Wiretapping's been carried out by most presidents, but it's bad when they get caught doing it. Blondie was a part of that CBGB crowd down in the Bowery in the early punk scene. Here's Debbie Harry and Blondie. They got me hanging on a telephone.
I'm in the phone booth. One across the hall.
Debbie Harry, lead singer of Blondie, has been in over 55 movies and TV shows. Perhaps she stole your heart away in a movie called Copland, which Sylvester Stallone gained 55 pounds for and took it all the way to the bank. It gets awful hot here in the summertime. Thank goodness you can open the windows in the Abernathy building. The only problem is you can hear the planes taking off from Zamudio International Airport. I apologize for the noise, but it is awful convenient when I want to get out of town in a hurry. Next up, Little Milton with Oliver Sane's orchestra. He was a blues guy who had later had a bunch of soul hits also. He started out on the Sun label with Sam Phillips, moved to East St. Louis, and was on the Bobbin record label. He was kind of a talent scout, too. He was the first guy that signed Albert King and Fontella Bass. A couple of his big hits were We're Gonna Make It, If Walls Could Talk, and the unforgettable Grits Ain't Groceries. I know the line is busy, but could you please try to reach her one more time? Little Milton, long distance operator. Little Milton, but he was 6'2". I met him once on the road. He was wearing them thick and thin silk socks. Inside one of them was a roll of $100 bills, and on his other ankle was a holster. The man obviously knew how to live on the road. Now we turn to the email part of our show. Tonight's email is from Don Foster from Silver Lake, California. He wants to know about Western swing legend Hank Penny. Thanks for asking, Don. Hank Penny never achieved the type of success that his fellow band leaders Bob Wills and Spade Cooley achieved. But then again, he never killed his wife like Spade Cooley did. Hank was born in 1918 in Birmingham, Alabama. His father was a coal miner who inspired Hank with his skills as a guitarist, a poet, and a magician. By the age of 15, Hank Penny was performing at local radio, and we're still playing him on Theme Time Radio Hour.
Hello? No, I'm sorry, you got the wrong number. But if you hold the phone, I'll tell you my story anyway. Now one night I had the cutest little gal you'll ever see. We were really stepping around, I thought, oh, lucky me. I noticed that she had that come-on look in those big eyes. But when I tried to kiss her, she said to my surprise, hold the phone, you've got the wrong party. Hold the phone, you're just an old smarty. Now I suggest you try another number, don't you see? The party that you want ain't here, so please don't bother me. One night she said she'd marry me. Oh, brother, what a life. a bungalow for two, this pretty creature for a wife. And when the parson asked her if she'd honor and obey, she looked the parson in the eye and answered him this way: Holophone, you got the wrong party, Holophone. You're just an old smarty. Now I suggest you try another number, don't you see? The party that you want ain't here, so please don't bother me. Been married for a year without a single fuss. One day she smiled and told me that the stork would visit us. He left a great big package, such a noise I've never heard. Two baby girls, a bouncing boy, here's what I told that bird: Holophone,
Holophone,
you've got the wrong party, Holophone,
Holophone,
you're just an old smarty. Now I suggest you try another number, don't you see? The party that you want ain't here, so please don't bother me.
Hold the phone, I'll tell you my story. A bungalow for two? Oh, lucky me. Hank Penny. I was over at Home Depot, had to get some wood. Who did I run into? That's right, Gina Gershon. Turns out she listens to the radio show. I told her about this week's subject, and we talked about a whole lot of things. Some of it I can share with you.
I don't know if this counts as a telephone song, but I remember hearing this mambo song with this telephone call right in the middle of it. I think it was by this woman named Graciela. I don't remember what they were talking about, but I remember I really liked the way it sounded. And I would really love it if you could play it for me, Bob.
Well, thanks, Tina. Salud.
¿Quién será ahora? ¿Halo?
Bueno.
¿Quién habla?
Ay, ¿no sabes quién te habla? Graciela, chica.
¿Quién?
Hoja Seca.
Ay, hojita, mi amor, mira que hacía tiempo que no me llamabas.
Ay, chica, tú sabes, no te llamaba porque la última vez que te llamé, tu marido estaba ahí, se te quemaron los frijoles.
No, pero niño, lo arreglé enseguida. Tú no sabes que me fui a la bodega, compré una lata de Goya y el niño ni se dio cuenta. Bueno, ¿y qué?
Bueno, ¿y él no está ahí ahora?
No, está de vacaciones en Puerto Rico.
¿A María en Puerto Rico?
Sí, tú sabes.
Ay, chica, te llamé para contarte el chisme del año.
¿Qué pasó?
Tú sabes que Carmen se casó hace dos semanas, ¿no?
Sí, ¿cómo no?
Y sabrás que se la llevaron de pronto al hospital con dolores de estómago.
¿Y eso qué, la pobre?
¿Y sabes el resultado?
¿Qué fue?
Tuvo una nena.
¿Una nena tan pronto?
Ay, chica, tú sabes que se le entrega por Special Delivery ahora.
Ay, hijo, qué bueno, qué manera yo de encargar una, porque ya no hay que pasar trabajo ni dolores. Bueno, ¿y qué pasó tú?
Ay, chica, yo trabajando muy duro y muy fuerte, porque quiero ver si voy allá a Dinamarca a cambiarme como la Jorgense.
Yo cargo la culpa. A mí el chisme me alimenta y me entretiene a la vez. Tú no ves que yo siempre ando por ahí caminando a ver lo que me puedo llevar, ¿no? El otro día pasé por un lugar y oí que estaban diciendo, ¿no?, que si fulano puso un huevo en el teatro. Bueno, ¿y qué? Si a cualquiera le pasa eso. Yo conozco muchos
que no llenan un salón de baile y siguen tocando, porque el mundo sigue su agitado curso, mi amor, tú sabes, ¿no? Hijo, y donde quiera que estamos nosotros existe el chisme, porque fíjate, que se van del barrio y lo llevan para cualquier lugar y sigue el chisme en su apogeo, porque eso es bueno y alimenta. ¿Cómo te gusta?
Soy David Hidalgo de Los Lobos. Están escuchando Theme Time Radio Hour con Bob Dylan.
Nobody sings a sad song like Aaron Neville. Every time the telephone rings, I hold my breath. I'm hoping it's you, I'm scared to death. Let it be you. A voice says hello, wrong number, I'm sorry, goodbye. I pity the fool who loves you so. If you found someone new, don't let me know. Can I speak to Ben? A voice says on the other end. Sorry, wrong number again.
Every time the telephone rings, I hold my breath, hoping that it's you. I'm scared to death. Phone went ring, my crippled heart cried. Let it be you on the line. Then a voice said hello. Can I speak to Joe? Wrong number, I'm sorry, goodbye. Pity the fool who loves you so. If you found someone new, don't let me know. The phone rang once again, my heart skipped a beat. Must be you, this is my belief. Then the voice on the other end said, can I speak to Ben? Wrong number, I'm sorry, goodbye. I live simply off the memory of your love that was once for me. Come back, my darling, please. And set my heart at ease. Then a voice said hello. Darling, you know I love you so. Hold on, baby, till I tell these blues goodbye. Till I tell these blues goodbye.
The distinctive voice of Aaron Neville. A lot of people think we sing the same.
Telephone for Mr. Olson. Hello? Who? The chambermaid.
Yeah. That's bad. That's good. That's good. That's bad. That's good.
Hey.
That's good.
Hey.
That's bad.
Hey, what are you doing?
What?
What are you doing?
I'm helping her sort a box of strawberries.
The telephone is ringing. Pee Wee Creighton on VJ Records. Pee-wee's from Texas. His real name is Connie Creighton. He moved to Los Angeles where he made most of his records. His biggest hit was called Blues After Hours. Other hits he had included Texas Hop and Papa Stoppa, named after the famous rhythm blues disc jockey. Though he was influenced by T-Bone Walker, he wasn't only an imitator. He was an exciting live performer. This is him singing about the telephone too. Telephone is ringing and my baby's on the line. I'm afraid to answer because I know what's on her mind.
Well, the telephone's ringing, and my baby's on the line. My baby's on the line. I'm afraid to even answer, 'cause I know what's on her mind. Well, she called me last night, round about 9 o'clock. Clean house, daddy, your mama's coming home to rock. My baby came home today. Telephone rang, and my baby came home today. I'm afraid to even answer, 'cause my baby's home to stay.
The telephone is ringing. Pee-wee Creighton. People say he took all his money and opened up a miniature golf course in Fresno. Creighton's pitching putt.
As step by step, we move toward the realization of Bell's early dream. His dream of a day when anyone, anywhere, can talk clearly and at a moment's notice with anyone, anywhere else.
Please hang up and try your call again. This is a recording.
Our 3 minutes are up here now for Theme Time Radio Hour, Dreams, Schemes, and Themes. But if you excuse me, I'm going to go make a few phone calls. See you next week.
Les filles, les garçons, et les filles ont tous qu'à chapiter. C'est normal, car on se réunit pour s'amuser. En jouant ensemble à un jeu qui n'est pas compliqué, le jeu du thé.
You've been listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan. Produced by Eddie Gorodetsky. Associate producer, Sonny Webster. Continuity by Eats Martin. Edited by Damian Rodriguez. Supervising editor, Rob McCumber. The Theme Time research team, Diane Lapson and Bernie Bernstein. With additional research by Lynn Sheridan, Kimberly Williams, and Robert Bauer. Production assistance by Jim McBeam. Special thanks to Randy Azradi, Debbie Sweeney, Coco Shinomiya, and Samson Snyder. For XM Radio, Lee Abrams. Recorded in Studio B, the Abernathy Building. Studio engineer, Tex Carbone. This has been a Greywater Park production in association with Big Red Tree. This is your announcer, Pierre Mancini, speaking. Join us again next week for Theme Time Radio Hour when the subject is water.